for loop and while loop. So we have an idea about how for loop works and how while loops are there. So while is like initialization, then while condition, and then some statements inside that, and after that iteration. Okay, so let me show you today one program related with while loop for calculation of factorial. Okay, how do we calculate the factorial of any number? So our program, and I am writing in negative, you must write it in positive. Write a program for calculation of factorial of any number using while loop and for loop. Okay, so initially integer main, then integer I fact equals to 1, then we use for loop, while loop, I equals to yes, number bhi to hona chahiye ki kis number ke liye aap kaam kar rahe ho. So that number we need to enter from user pen. Printf slash n, enter any number between 0 to any number, any positive number, any non-negative number. Fine. So initially we have write the value of factorial as 1. Okay, why it is written? Because factorial of 0 is 1. Now scanf percent d and address of n. So I need one more variable here, n. Okay, now after that factorial is initialized to 1 while I is greater than or equals to 2. Okay, fact equals to fact multiplied by I. So what is the initial value of I? You must know it. 1. No, actually the initial value of I am putting here. Okay, I is, oh, it is, I am not able to put here also. So this program, I am putting the value of I equals to n, whatever user had given. Okay, now till I is greater than or equals to 2, it will calculate factorial equals factorial multiplied by I, then I minus minus, and finally it will print factorial of percent d equals to percent t. slash n, don't forget to write slash n over some places. Okay, now yes, there is one more thing. If I am not giving any variable, then what will be shown here? Yes or no? So factorial of n is fact. Okay, and then return 0. And then termination of program. Now let us see how these variable impact. Initially we have declared I fact to 1 and one value is taken as n. Okay, now in next subsequent line I equals to n. Okay, whatever value may be there, suppose it is 5. So this will be 5. So user has entered, you know how it will be entered by user. Now from this line, I am starting the execution. So what is our initial value of factorial? It is 1, initial value, okay? Now let us see what will happen here. So initialization is already given here. The I's initialization is 5. Now it will become 5, okay? So let me start looping first. So put the value of I here. Then next is condition. I is greater than or equals to 2 or not. And then value of fact, that is equals to fact multiplied by I. And I minus minus. Okay. So initial value of I is 5. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
User has entered 5 because you know that it will be printed like enter any number, enter any non-negative number. I had entered 5. Now 5 will be entered. So let me check whether 5 is greater than or equals to 2 or not. Yes, 5 is greater than or equals to 2. Okay. Now, what is the, this is L value. L value must be variable. Okay. Now R value. What is the current value of factorial? It is 1. Multiplied by what is the value of I? This is 5. Okay. Now it will give you 5. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let me. I minus minus. Now the value of I is decremented by 1. Next value is 4. Value of I is decremented by 4. Now the value of I becomes 4. Whether 4 is greater than or equals to 2? Yes, it is true. Then factorial equals to, what is the current value of factorial? 5. And what is the value of I? 4. 5 multiplied by 4. It will give you 20. And now the value of I is decremented by 1. So it will become 3. Then 3 is also greater than or equals to 2. Fact equals to 20. Current value of factorial is 20. 20 multiplied by 3. It will give you 60. And then this is decremented by 1 and 2. Now 2 is also greater than or equals to. 2 is actually equals to, it is not greater than. So this condition also becomes true. Then fact equals to 60 multiplied by 2. This I is 2 and this fact value is 60. Okay. Now what will be the answer? 120. And this will become 1. This condition is false. Now we exit. Exit from while loop. Okay, and after that this statement will be executed. So what is this statement? Factorial of person D. So what is this person D? This person D is n. So what is the value of n? N is not changed here. Okay, only factorial and I will be changed. You can see that n is never changed here. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
We have not altered n. Okay. Now, factorial of this n. N is, what is the value of n? N is 5. 5 equals to, what is the value of factorial now? This value is taken from here. So this is 120. Now the answer is 120. Yes or no? In this program, any problem is there? Yes. No problem?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. So let me, whether it is required to show you by for loop also? So let me do one thing. I will show you how for loop will work. Okay. So I am highlighting one box. Only this much thing will be, it is required to change. Okay. And remaining all other things are same. Now, if I am going to convert this into for, then what will be the writing of code? Okay. Remaining all statements are same. Only I am changing the while. I am converting this while into for loop. Okay. So now, initialization for initialization is I equals to n. I is greater than or equals to 2, then I minus minus. Okay. And after that, fact equals to fact multiplied by I. You can see clearly here, if I am showing you, again go to highlighter and let me change the color of highlight. Okay. I need to change the color of highlighting green. So this is our condition, yes or no? I equals to n. So I equals to n is the initialization. Yes, sir. Then condition is given as I greater than or equals to, and then iteration is I minus. So is it very easy to convert from while to for? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now your task is to create the same program using positive while loop. This is negative, I minus minus is there. Now you need to create the same program for I plus plus. Are you able to create this? Just try to create. And you have only 3 minutes, okay? At 9:40, I will take over. So better only just you need to write, and don't write while, just write for loop only. Positive for loop.
So for loop. So what we have to do?
Yes.
So what we have to do?
You need to calculate factorial by using positive loop. Means I had calculated factorial like 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2. You need to calculate it from 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So a slight modification is required. So just okay. I will give you 5 minutes is sufficient. And don't see the internet, okay? Because in internet it is already given. So let me not disturb you, all of you. हो गया सभी का? किसी ने लिखा या बस बैठे रहे कि सर खुद ही बता देंगे करके?
सर
यस
सर, इन व्हाइल व्हाइल में हम लोग वो जो ब्रैकेट है उसमें हम लोग दो कंडीशन डाल सकते हैं।
भाई मैंने तो आपको फॉर से बोला, व्हाइल से तो बोला ही नहीं।
अच्छा ठीक है सर, तो मैंने लिखा है आई इज ग्रेटर देन वन कॉमा आई इज स्मॉलर देन इक्वल टू एन।
ग्रेटर देन वन एंड स्मॉलर देन इक्वल्स टू, दो कंडीशन की जरूरत ही नहीं है वैसे, सिंगल कंडीशन में गया
सर। लेकिन आई प्लस प्लस है तो आई वन से चालू करना पड़ेगा ना?
बता रहा हूँ ना मैं, देखो अब इनिशियली व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ आई, इट इज एन इनिशियली, बट नाउ इन दिस प्रोग्राम वी विल नॉट डूइंग लाइक दिस। ओके, इन दिस फॉर आई इक्वल्स टू टू, आई इज लेस देन और इक्वल्स टू एन एंड आई प्लस प्लस। ओके, एंड देन वी स्टार्ट राइटिंग फैक्ट equals to fact multiplied by I, and then this program will work fine. And similarly, if you are converting this into while, so for while I equals to 2, initialization is there. Okay, this is using for and this is using while. Okay, so I equals to 2 while I is less than or equals to n, fact equals to fact multiplied by I, and then I plus plus, and finally this will turn. Okay, now let us see how it will work. So initial value of fact is given as 1 and the value entered by user is 5 suppose. Okay, so this we are not using, our initialization is entirely different. Okay, and again you can see that nowhere n is involved. Okay, only this n is for limiting, but nowhere n is directly altered by this program. Now I, then I is less than or equals to n, and then fact equals to fact multiplied by I, and then I plus plus. Okay, so initial value of I is 2. Why 2? Because already we have expressed fact equals to 1. If the value is entered by user is 0, then its factorial is 1, and if the value entered by user is 1, this is also 1. So in both the cases 1 will be coming. Now the for loop will start from I equals to 2, I is less than or equals to 2. Suppose user has entered 1. Okay, so when 1 will be entered, I is less than or equals to n. So what is the value of n? N is, oh, okay, it will work forever, but initial value of I is 2 and already the value of n is 1. So whether 2 is less than or equals to n? No. So it will automatically exit from this loop. Okay, or from this loop. So let me start for 5. So initial value of I is 2. It is true. Then fact equals to fact. What is the value of fact? Initial value of fact is 1. 1 multiplied by 2 will give you 2. And then the value of I will become 3. Then 3 is also less than or equals to 5. Then this is 2 multiplied by I's value is 3. Okay, it will give you 6. then this will be incremented to 4. Now come to 4. After this 4, 4 is less than or equals to 5. Yes. So it will be next value of factorial is 6 and the value of I is 4. So it will give you 24 and then it will be incremented by 1. Now 5 is also less than or equals to, actually 5 is equals to 5. Then this will be 24 multiplied by 5. It will give you 120 and this is 6. 6 is less than or equals to n. No, exit. Okay, from while or for loop. And then finally it will print whatever you want. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So is it easy to write program in negative and positive direction? Yes or no? Is it easy or not? Or it is tough? Okay. You are not able to answer actually. So formulating algorithm with top-down approach, problem becomes develop a class of averaging problem, arbitrary number of use sentinel value. Maine bataya tha aapko, how do we use sentinel value and why sentinel value will be taken, and this we have done, how to calculate the average of 10 students' marks. Okay. Now, anybody is having this problem related with post-increment and pre-increment?
Yes, sir. Very correct.
Once more, you want explanation of this?
Yes, sir.
Suppose this is known as pre-increment because increment operator is put before the operand, and this is post-increment. Okay. Now, suppose the value of I is 5. And you are writing, and let me check some other value. Maybe 3. Okay. So if I equals to 3, and the box shows the memory. Okay. Box shows the memory, and initially the value of I is 3. Okay, for all other lines also. So I am writing I plus 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 I plus plus. Then what will be the answer? So in this particular case, it will take the value of I first and then increment. Okay, then increment by 1. And this will take the value of I and then increment. Okay, so the answer of this question is 7. Second problem, I plus 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 I. Okay. So it will take the It will take the value first. What is the value? We are solving for I equals to 3. So it will take the value first, then increment later. Then it will increment first. Increment first means what will be the value here? 5, and then use later. So this will give you 8. Okay. If you change the sequence, it will change the answer. Now come to next. Plus plus I, then I plus plus. Okay. So in this particular case, be careful. The value of I is 3. Okay. Value of I is 3. value of I is 3. Now, if the value of I is 3, it will use later, it will increment first. So the value of I is 4. Then it will not use the value. Okay. Till now, it will not use the value. After that, in the same increment operator, it will use the value. It will use the value and then increment. Okay. So what is the value of increment? Value of increment is 5. So now the answer is 9. Okay. Then fourth case.
So third case.
Third case once again. This plus plus I will increment the value first. So it has increment. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now it will not use until the next operand is there. Okay. So what is our next operand? Next operand is I plus plus. So I plus plus will use value first. Will use value first. Then increment. Okay. And this is the final value of I. It will be used later. So this 5 will be used here. This 4 will be used here because of this increment. Okay. So current value of I was 4 and this I was used here. So that's why it is 9. Yes or no?
Yes,
let
sir.
Let me explain one more problem. Then I think you will be sure. It will increment the value use later, increment the value use later. Now the final increment is done. So 5 plus 5 gives you 10. Okay. So let me show you it by a programming experiment also. And suppose you have given 3, okay, plus plus I plus I plus 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 I. So what will be the result? So make parenthesis first, okay, solve for this. 3 is given. So in memory, it will increment first in memory and it will not use any value. It will use the value because I is written first, then increment next. Okay, so this will become 5 plus 4 and the current value of I is what? Current value of I is 5. Okay, so now it will increment first. So this will increment first. And then this will use the value later because no other operands are there. So answer is 15. Any other problem you want to know? Ho jayega solve aap logon se? Are you able to solve all these problems? Just show me the output of this, okay?
Okay, sir.
Yes. What will be the output of this problem? Just calculate it and show me. Initial value of I is 3. आ गया आंसर?
सर 13।
यस
13।
13। ओके 13 कैसे आएगा लेकिन? हाउ? एनी अदर?
22।
ओके एनी अदर?
23।
एनी अदर गैसेस? 25 13 12 22 23 25. Okay, suppose these are option given to you. Let us start solving this problem. So this will increment first, use letter. This will also increment first, use letter. 5 plus 5. Okay, now next box will start here. What is the current value of I? 5. Increment first. Okay, use letter. It will use first, increment later. Okay, then this value will be used. Now the answer is 10 plus 13. It will give you 23. 23 is the right answer. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Nested control structure. A college has a list of test result. One before going.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, midterms में sir question कैसे format में आएंगे?
अभी तक तो objective ही सुना है हमने.
अच्छा तो sir जैसे coding के questions as multiple choice में कैसे आएंगे?
पूछा जाएगा what will be the output of this program. If the output of this program is given, then what will be the missing line?
अच्छा, okay sir.
ठीक है. Okay. So before going to explain the just show me how this loop will be executed. Okay, the theory is given there and I am showing you from here. Control new, control M. And carefully see the program. Okay. ये एक स्पेस है और इसके बाद मैंने डाला है स्टार. सो दिस इज आवर प्रोग्राम. Okay, how many for loops are there?
Two
for loop. Okay, so how do we execute? and let me execute it for 5 only, not go beyond this, because 5 is very easy to understand. So for I equals to I and J, we have given J and I. So let me write I sequence in horizontal direction and J sequence in this direction. Okay. So how this value of I will be implemented? So what is the value of I? I will start from 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And J, value of J depends on I, because what is written here? J is less than or equals to I. So the first loop for I, how many times J will run? J will run from for this much, okay? And in next case, J will run for 1 and 2. In next case, 1, 2, and 3. In next case, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And in next case, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Let us see what will be the output. So in this particular case, okay, in this particular case, for this for loop, okay, for outer for loop, it will run once and it will print what it will print, space followed by star. Okay, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Then this loop will exit. This loop will exit because for J equals to 1, 2, J equals to 1. J plus plus, so automatically this loop will exit. And now printf new line. So now the control will come to new line. Okay. And then again it will start for I equals to. Now what is the value of I? So I is 2. Now for this, J equals to 1 and 2. It will run 2 times. It will run 2 times. And from left, it will start this and then this. Okay. 2 times it will print. First time and second time. No slash n is given inside that loop. Okay. After that, slash n will come. And in third time, it will print 3 times the star. Okay. And in fourth line, it will print 4 times the star. And in fifth line, it will print 5 times the star. 4 and 5. Okay. So this is our final output. Now, your problem is you need to print star like this. How many it will be entered by the user? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and likewise. Actually, this is wrong. So this is your home assignment. After that, it will print 3 star. So this problem is known as to print a pyramid. Okay. Pyramid of size n. So it is your problem, and you can see this problem can be solved by 3 for loop. Okay, you need 3 for loop, and this star pattern follows one blank. Okay, every star follows a blank. It will not it will not make the blank in head. And how many blanks are there? So you need to check how many blanks are there, and after that, what is the pattern of blank? Then what is the pattern of blank, and what is the pattern of blank, and likewise. So it will definitely give you 1 star. So tomorrow I will ask, okay, and try to give me the right answer, because the program is already available in internet. So thus try to use this kind of for loop and try to understand what will be the pattern. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Yes. Now there is concept of two for loop. There will be concept of two for loop. Okay, so you just need to read this. I had already shown actually here it has used one for loop, and this is very simple thing. So I'm not going to explain you. I had explained that two for loop, concept of two for loop. Now assignment operator. So assignment operators abbreviated as assignment operators abbreviate assignment expressions like C equals to C plus 3. You know what is the meaning of this? C equals to C plus 3 means C and equals to C and n minus 1 plus 3. It means the previous answer plus new value gives you new answer. Yes or no? Cn equals to Cn minus 1 plus 3. You can write likewise. So this expression and this expression is same. Statement of the form variable equals to variable operator expression. And it can be rewritten as variable operator equals to expression. Suppose you want to increment, you want to create each increment by 3. So you can write C plus equals to 3. Okay. This is having the same meaning. Also, C equals to C plus 3 is also same thing. Okay. So here, what is the meaning of this? D minus equals to 4 means D equals to D minus 4. E equals to E multiplied by 5. F equals to F divided by 3 and G equals to G mod 9. Okay, so you must remember these operators, these assignment operators. Increment and decrement, I had explained you. Okay, post increment, pre increment. If C equals to 5, then what will be the output? It will print 6, it will print 5. Okay, pre increment. Post increment have the same effect if it is executed before. If it is written here, then it will give you the same answer. So with this, we finish today's class and I will ask, okay, tomorrow I think there will be a class.
Yes, sir.